Hello, I'm Tom.
I'm Kevin.
I'm Vincent.
And today we are going to talk about the topic, a comparison crowdfunding website in Taiwan and the US. And we take Kickstarter and Flybee for example. First, what's crowdfunding? Crowdfunding is the practice of funding a project or venture by raising money from a large number of people. And do you guys know anything around you that actually comes from crowdfunding? Here we list six commonly seen examples. First, 看见 Taiwan. Second, 3D printer, 3D电影机. And the third one, Formosa Cup, 月亮杯. Fourth, 太阳花学运. Fifth, 又烂尾计划. And the sixth, 欢声回家. And 这是多的. And for 又烂尾计划, 欢声回家, 太阳花学运, and 看见 Taiwan, these four are actually came from Flying Bee. Flying Bee, the most representative platform for Taiwan. And it was started on April 23rd in 2012. And these two are the founders of Flying Bee, Zheng Guangting and Li Hongquan. And especially for Zheng Guangting, there's a little story of why he wanted to start it. Why he wanted to start Flying Bee. Zheng Guangting was a co-founder of Rage.cc, also known as Wumi Xiao Zhan, and he had lots of ideas in his mind. And he left Yahoo because of the limitation of a big corporation. And during a year of introspection on his entrepreneurial direction and motivation, in 2012, he created Flying Bee to help those entrepreneurs who have ideas but no money to fulfill their dreams. He said he used to dream of being a singer in his young age, but this idea was ultimately discarded because he couldn't live on it. And that's why he wanted to create Flying Bee. He wanted to help those who face financial difficulties to realize their dreams. And this is the most successful project, 金圈新时代中文字行. It had funded almost 26 million by 7,600 backers. And
there was a short story before there was a story found. After finishing shooting the film team found itself in lack of the marketing budget to play in the theater. So the director, decided to hold an open air movie. Tried out at 11th Square, that is 自由广场. Some media had no desire to report it, and others reported particles. So the participants came up with an idea of trying to spread the correct information to the world. They initially tried to raise a fund of 1.5 million so that they could place on April day, but it turned out that the result was beyond their expectations. They made it on two times since they raised 7 million.
Next, we want to talk about the biggest crowdfunding platform in the world. Its name is Kickstarter. It is established by Perry Chang on April 2008 in 2007. He's the founder of Kickstarter. And the reason why he wants to start a project such as Kickstarter is that he wanted to hold a jazz music program, a jazz music festival, but he didn't have enough money to rent the location. So he thought if he can get the money of the tickets first, then he wouldn't have to worry about the money. And this simple idea is the beginning of Kickstarter. And according to this bar chart, we can see film, video, and music are the highest banking amount categories. And the most successful project is Pebble's eWatch. It accumulates the highest backing amount of money in Kickstarter.
And this is the evolution time. Kickstarter started at April 2020 in 2009, and Flying Wing started at April 2006 in 2009. And this is the rate of successful projects. Kickstarter has 75.7 and Flying Wing at 50%. And this is the eligible country for project. We can see Kickstarter have many countries and Flying Wing just have Taiwan. Based on the eligible country, Kickstarter have many people and Flying Wing just have those people. And in Taiwan, there's 48% people doesn't hurt the crowdfunding. And 15% people heard of Kickstarter. And 14.8% people heard Flying Wing in Taiwan. And in the USA, they have jobs. It's the law of the crowdfunding. And Taiwan and this is the compare between 5B and Kickstarter.
And according to some famous projects in Taiwan, such as Jingxuan, 新时代中文字型, and 歌兰伟计划, you can see Taiwanese passion and interest for helping people. And if the government can make some special laws to help the young entrepreneur, there will be a brighter outlook for them. And finally, we wanted to say, life's going on. The more we try, the more we gain. There's a lesson in each experience. Every failure is the stepping stone to success. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, rest if you must, don't you quit. The success is closer than you thought. And this is the end of our speech. Thanks for your listening.
Thank you.